gather round me one and all, and tell me if you've heard of the short unhappy life of the sailor Thomas Bird. He died upon the gallows, forsaken by his mates, the first man executed by the young United States. He was an Englishman by birth and a sailor by his trade. His life at sea began when he was but 8 years of age. From Bristol to Barbados, Liverpool to Africa, he shipped on board the favorite, the Vulcan and Bombay. The Vulcan and Bombay, the Vulcan and Bombay. He shipped on board the favorite, the Vulcan and Bombay. Shipwreck and hard labor and the pest gangs of the crown, but his fate was sealed one August morn on the docks of Portsmouth town. He signed on board the Mary with John Connor in command, and they were bound for slaving to the black man's native land. Now this Connor was a devil, and his ship a floating hell. The crew he did abuse in ways too horrible to tell. The mate he cruelly murdered, struck him down with his own hand. At last the crew could bear no more, and a mutiny they planned. Mutiny they planned, a mutiny they planned. At last the crew could bear no more, and a mutiny they planned. When the Mary docked in Falmouth town, the crew in number 3, and Hanson, Bird and Jackson soon embarked upon a spree. They'd no captain and no cargo, and when asked to tell their tale, they put to sea to run away, but were caught and thrown in jail. Jackson bought his freedom by accusing Thomas Bird, and in the new formed federal courts his case the judges heard. The jury reached its verdict, and out the sentence rang: for murder on the high seas you are condemned to hang. You are condemned to hang. You are condemned to hang. For murder on the high seas, you are condemned to hang. The morning of his hanging, Thomas Bird was in his cell. Called for pen and paper, his life story for to tell. The dying speech of Thomas Bird, the memoir he did name. He'd barely time to tell his tale before the marshal came. I acknowledge that I've sinned, he wrote, I've lived a wicked life with profanity and drunkenness, my existence has been rife. But with God as my witness, and as a dying man, I declare that I am innocent of the death of any man. The death of any man, the death of any man. I am innocent of the death of any man.